Okay, guys, we are live. All right, we're live.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hey, we're live. Hi. Welcome to Rough with Artist Episode 1. We are Arts Talk PH. And tonight, we're with Marika Kalyangan of Woman Create, Mara Fabella, Annalie Angeles, and my co-founder, Marianne Manzano. And just give a background, we are Art Talk PH, so we're an online platform that aims to make selecting and buying art more convenient and accessible by connecting artists with collectors, buyers, the fan base, and of course, the curious. We also will be creating content with the artists. And what's really cool about Art Talk PH is we enable artists to join exhibitions, create content with us, and sell their art without leaving their homes or their studios. Did I say that right, Mary?
Yes, you did. Very much so. I love that Sunshine is like the first here on our comment stream. Hello, Sunshine. Thank you so much for watching. And as usual, so this is what she said, that we are all gorgeous. We are all gorgeous, including Sunshine. Sunshine is one of our artists in artstalkph.com. So just to let all of our viewers know, just visit the website because our gallery is completely online. That was the point of this whole thing, that we wanted something that is a platform for both artists and collectors to share, to be able to find art even though they're not able to really go to galleries at the moment. Okay, so I'll be going backstage now. And I will leave the floor to these beautiful ladies. And the Fab will be the one moderating for today. So this is Brush with Artists Episode 1. Okay, and let's see, our Episode 1 title is Feminism, Males, and Studies. You guys move out, and I'll see you guys later.
Hey. Okay. Okay, let's start with Marika.
Hi.
Hi, Marika.
Hello.
Hello. Okay, so my first question for Marika, actually, and we are also going to have questions, entertain questions from the audience later. But for now, this is something that I actually am eager for you to share to our audience. So your question is, How did you start Woman Create?
All right. Okay.
Can you tell us more about how you started? What inspired you to start Woman Create?
Okay. So Woman Create started back in 2015. I was going through a rough patch. Like, I was diagnosed with this reproductive chronic disease called endometriosis, and parang what would happen is I would deal with like pain, and then there are high chances that I wouldn't like give birth. And so that made me go through like this crisis, this parang identity crisis. So parang, oh, as a woman, I thought we were, because like for the last 25 years of my life, I thought that the sole core identity of a woman is to get married and have kids.
Motherhood.
That was the old me, you know? And then it made me really question, like, what if you weren't able to do that? Like, are you still a woman? Like, are you still, like, a real woman? And so I decided, I was in a bad place back then. And then I found art. I started by making collages, mostly digital collages. And then I wanted to share my story with a lot of women, because I thought a lot of women, you know, they don't always feel so empowered. They don't always feel great. They're going through different issues, heartbreak, identity crisis. And I wanted to create this platform where I could make art at the same time, kind of share it, and hopefully people would end up resonating with it. And they do, for some reason. And so that's how Woman Create started, and it's still running until now. And I'm really grateful for the community that that has come, you know, over the years.
Yeah, and we worked on an exhibit back in 2000. 2018, December. Yeah, and Mara was also part of that exhibit. I remember, and that's the first time I saw Marika speak in front of her audience, and how she's just so empowered to talk about her experiences and how she started Woman Create. Thank you, Marika. I'm going to ask now, Annalie. Hi, Annalie. Thank you for joining us.
Hello. Thank you. I love your
yeah, yeah. Yes. I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Cool. Okay. So with Annalie naman, her art, I would normally describe your art as ethereal. And you portray women, portraits of women. Mm. Like the first time I met you, your paintings have been women. And these are women, yeah, in different circumstances. So my question for you is, how do you select your subjects? Like, is there a process for you to like create these women paintings? Do you like go through like, you know, storyboard or something with creating them? Can you tell us more about it?
Actually, ano siya? More on kasi quick background, kasi parang nag-umpisa talaga ako na before magsulat talaga ng tula. So may time sa akin na parang hindi ko na siya ma-express into words. So parang ang ginawa ko, why not ipaint ko na lang siya, kasi parang mas gusto ko siyang i-express, pero at the same time ayoko siyang i-put into words, kasi nga parang ang hirap na rin hanapin ng mga salita, parang ganon. So tinry ko na siyang ilipat sa painting. Tapos ang process ko naman doon, yung emotions, parang mag-internalize muna ako, ganun, i-dwell ko muna yung mga emotions kung ano man. Tapos meron kasing visualization eh, parang alam mo yun, na-visualize mo kung ano yung subject mo, parang ano yung emotion ng subject mo, ano yung sinasabi ng mata niya, ng bibig niya, yung katawan niya, parang ganun. So parang pag na-visualize ko na siya, gagawa ako ng study, parang ganyan. So for me, para ma-perfect ko yung study ko, naghahanap ako ng references, kasi kailangan ko na accurate siya or proportion, ganyan. So minsan pipicturean ko yung sarili ko para makuha ko eksakto yung proportion na gusto ko. At the same time, na drawing ko or na paint ko exactly yung na visualize ko, parang ganun.
Was there ever a time, I'm curious, was there ever a time where you saw one woman and you wanted to paint her as your subject and then like portray her in a different light, in a way?
Maraming beses. Pero usually, artist din. Pero musicians, parang ganun. Pero ang ginagawa ko kasi, yung music nila yung pinipaint ko than yung picture nila or image nila. So, kunwari, na-touch ako ng song nila. Well, nagpipaint, paulit-ulit ko lang piniplay yung song nila. So, parang ganun. Yung music niya, nililipat ko siya into painting, parang ganun. So, parang yung gusto niyang sabihin, nilipat ko rin siya into painting, parang ganun. Ganun yung process ko. Or kung meron man akong gustong tao na i-paint, parang ganun.
Okay, nice. So, when you say you're painting music, can you give an example? Sorry, ang daming questions. I'm really curious. Can you explain kahit like in two sentences, maybe? Can you explain what you mean by you're painting music, their music instead?
Kasi, di ba, parang complete na rin naman yung emotions ng music. Kasi may andun na yung lyrics, andun na yung melody. So parang yung pakiramdam, parang ma-interpret mo na siya eh. Parang andan na yung, ito yung nararamdaman ko habang pinapakinggan ko yung music, parang ganyan. So, ayun, parang, ewan ko kung normal lang sa ating mga artist din, na merong tayong na-visualize automatic, diba? Parang, ito na yung nasa isip natin. Pag may narinig tayong ganitong bagay or what, ito na yon. So parang, kunyari na nakapakinig ako ng isang song nung isang artist na medyo empty, ganyan, or what. So, ganun ko rin siya ipoportray. Parang ganun. Pero hindi...
Yeah, I think,
Pero hindi...
I know what you mean.
Ako rin ganun.
Like, sometimes when you hear music and then this feels like rainbows, or like this feels like it has good vibes. Parang ganun. And then you try to translate it into your painting. Okay. I get it. Thank you. Thank you, Annalie. Now let's move on to Mara. Hi, Mara.
Hi.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining us tonight. So, Mara naman creates really dreamlike. That's what I would say. It's like something that you would see in dreams, your pieces. Same with Marika. Your pieces, they're parang surreal. The two of you, you create out of cutouts, images, and different materials, you create one piece and it forms a completely different narrative, like a completely different piece. So my question for Mara is, so I remember when we were writing your bio, you mentioned that you really love tales and stories and narratives, and that's also why you're a writer. So how does your love for tale translate into your art? Like, how did it, you know, how did it end up being what it is now?
Yeah, well, I grew up, like I'm sure a lot of us did, on stories like Star Wars, Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, you know, those classic stories. And they were something very formative and very important personally to me. So parang that is what started that love of something like fantastical for me, something out of the ordinary. That's why I always stick to fantasy and sci-fi stories. I find like the normal romance or something, it bores me. So when I studied art formally, like in college, I found that kind of synergy, that energy in studying, in creating collage. So it's that idea of like taking something from another source and maybe something else, maybe two, three, or as many different elements as you want, and putting it, forming something new out of it. So it's like, for me, I think of it as storytelling. So yeah, so just like I was influenced by stories, I like my works to be seen as kind of visual stories as well.
Yeah, I see that actually. I see that. Even if they're coming from different, like cutouts from different magazines, a face from some page of a book, it does tell one solid narrative once you see them, the finished artwork.
Yeah. Thank yeah, you. Like,
oh yeah, go ahead. You're saying something.
Okay. No, like, my works now, they're abstracted, so I know it can be kind of a bit more difficult to see, like, what story does this tell? But for me, I like kind of looking at those, like, small little, like, scraps of paper, and I like people wondering, like, where did this come from? Like, what could this be? Is this, like, clothes? Is it, like, I don't know, rocks or something? And kind of guessing what it could be, what it could form.
Yeah, I see that. Yeah, later we're going back with Marika, because Marika's piece is actually the symbolism of Marika's piece is, yeah, Shards of My Anxiety. So for the three of you, I have a question. So, based on all of these influences, Marika with establishing Woman Create, Mara with her visual narratives, her art being influenced by tales, and Annalie, her art being influenced, now I know, influenced by music and by the women that you know. So how did these influences actually affect or help develop your current creative process, your current artistic process? Like with Marika, for example, she is also a teacher. And so how does your teaching, how does your creative process, your creating process, how are they affected by these influences? So this question is for the three of you. So who wants to answer first?
Let's start with Annalie.
Thank you. Hindi, may time naman din talaga tayo mga artist na meron tayong artist block. Parang ganun. So, parang minsan, nahihirapan ka rin makakuha ng inspiration, parang mga ganyan. So, sila, may binibigyan nila ako minsan ng narrative or story na pwede kong ikwento rin. Hindi lang dahil nakarelate ako, o kasi baka yung iba din pwedeng makarelate. So, usually ganun. Parang binibigyan nila ako ng bagong story, bagong perspective, mga ganun. Ganun sila nakakatulong sa akin. Tsaka syempre, yung outlook din nila sa art nila or sa music nila, medyo nakaka-influence din siya sa artwork ko din. Kung paano ko rin i-imply yung kung ano mang pinaniniwalaan nila or yung sinasabi nila through music nila, sa art ko naman rin. Parang ganun. Parang natutulungan nila ako na i-widen pa yung knowledge na kung ano mang meron na ako. Parang ganun.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, that's true. I keep telling some of my other artist friends too that we can draw inspiration from all sorts of things. Kasi nauubos yung inspiration. We have to keep feeding it. Marika, your turn.
All right. So first, you asked how does it influence my work as a teacher? How does it influence my art? So, as an art teacher specifically, I think it's important that the teacher knows the subject. No, so there's a lot that I end up really studying. Like I go to the books, I make studies like as if I'm a student all over again, and I love it. I love how I'm re-studying Western art history. I'm also studying Philippine history, and like, you know, I'm trying to bring some dead people to life, and hopefully they also kind of, their stories also impact me, like now in 2020. And right now I'm collage is about being able to associate one image, you know, to something like into a metaphor. It can be related to you, it can be related to other people, but overall my whole point in making art is to kind of put my voice out there, you know, because women have been omitted in history, and like really the feminist core. While my subjects are not really purely feminist, like politically feminist, but it's the action itself, you know, that I want, like putting our stories out there, reclaiming women and women empowerment and who we are, our identity. Like I want to put that in art, and I don't want to do it in a traditional way. I kind of want to do it in a way that disrupts people, like, oh, is this art? Yung ganon, parang hindi naman ganon. May or may not be beautiful to some people, but then do women have to always be beautiful, you know? But why are we so insecure all the time living up to society standards? So I kind of want to put those types of ideas in my act of art making. So yeah, so my visual style is still developing, and everyone can see me develop through my social media. So thanks, guys.
Yeah, actually, yeah, I've seen your art develop also since I met you. Yeah. And I've seen also how Women Create develop since I met you. Now let's go to Mara. Mara?
Well, okay, I cited like books and stories as my influences. One of the authors that I think has been really has really helped inform my visual style and how I approach art is Neil Gaiman. So I'm glad, Fab, that you mentioned like the words like surreal and dreamlike for my works a while ago, because I'd associate that also with Neil Gaiman. He's somebody who, as a creative, I think is very unapologetically weird. It's like you can like put this kind of imagery into the world, you don't have to explain it, like that's, you know, that's your vision. So I kind of like to, so parang that kind of influence has made me become a lot more spontaneous. And yeah, hopefully a lot more unapologetic with my imagery. So when I collage things, you know, I like this like certain like form, it looks kind of weird. So I'll cut it and I'll put it on my canvas. So yeah, I think it's helped me become a bit, a lot more intuitive and kind of come to terms with that very hard to explain way of creating art.
Actually. And plus, you also write, so I really, yeah, Mara writes really well. Yeah. I like how she gave me enough material to write about her art.
I was really well like cramming that. I was like, no, I have to write it this way.
Yeah, thank you, Mara. I believe we have a question from our audience, Mary. Oh, okay, so we have a question from Camille. If you liken the art to music, what would be the genre of your art? Okay, so I'm guessing this is, I mean, you, all of you can answer it actually if you want, but I feel like this is for Annalie, but feel free to answer, ladies.
Kung magiging music siya, siguro blues or jazz. Minsan pop. Ah, ganun.
It really depends on the mood. Hirap yung tanong. Thank you very much for the question.
Hirap kasi i-conclude in one ano genre. Yeah. Parang ganun.
Right.
But I think we would agree that it really depends on oh yeah, Camille did say it's for Annalie, the question. But yeah, I think we can all say that it also depends on the mood. But you mentioned earlier jazz. I sometimes do see jazz in your art, Annalie.
Talaga ba?
You ladies want to answer? Anyone, no?
But I haven't really thought of like associating my art with the kind of music. Like, I listen to music then when creating my pieces, but I listen to a whole lot of stuff. Sometimes I'm listening to like pop, sometimes it's Broadway, Disney musicals. So I guess that also describes like my process then. Like, iba-iba, it could be different things.
Right, I agree. So, like, yeah. I used to make music. I used to make music. I made a collage piece based on Ariana Grande before, for like an art for med commission. Oh yeah, sobrang gulo. So I don't. Tama nga si Annalie, but you can't categorize it in like one genre. How about like all? We can do it all.
I remember those Marika, parang you had some na Star Wars pa, diba?
Oh, yeah.
Those collages. Yeah,
diba? Yeah. Anyway. I think I remember that also. The one with Padme.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it that one? Yeah. The one with Padme.
Yeah.
Okay. Star Wars. We have another, actually, we have another question from the audience. Oh, it's for Annalie again. Let me. So the question is, have your subjects, have they always been women and why?
Siguro nagkataon lang na mga babae sila. Kasi mas madali silang i-convey. Parang yung kung ano mang nararamdaman, mas madali silang ilipat into women, parang ganun. Pero feeling ko naman nagkataon lang kasi yung emotions naman, pain or happiness, it's universal naman siya. It doesn't belong in a certain gender. So, hindi ko pa alam kung kailan ako makapag-paint na subject na ibang gender naman. Pero I wanted to be accurate, no? Parang mabibigyan, maji-justify ko yung subject itself sa painting. Parang ayoko na basta mag-drawing lang ako na isang gender na hindi ko naman siya ma-justify. Parang hindi nagtutugma yung emotion dun sa image. So parang siguro in time, mag-ready na ako or confident na ako, baka makita sila ng ibang gender naman sa artwork ko. Parang ganun.
We'll definitely wait for that. We have another question. This one is for Marika naman. So what are the shards made of and how did the piece come to life? I think this is regarding your Shards of My Anxiety piece that is part of Hindsight is 2020, our maiden exhibit. So
The shards are made out of my anxiety. Just kidding. Okay, so the shards are made out of a broken plate. So the night before, I suffered a panic attack because of what was happening, like, in our country and in the world. And sobrang nagpa-panic lang ako about, like, basta nagka-panic attack ako. And then the next day, I didn't sleep well. I was so out of it. I accidentally broke a plate. And then I was still so out of it. So, pero habang naglilinis ako, I was like, oh, look at that piece of, it's pretty. Like, I mean, like, in the midst of all this anxiety, parang naisip ko pa, ay, ang ganda na, no? And then I decided to pick some pieces up and then preserve them. And then it just so happened that, you know, I still had to calm down. So, I wanted to kind of, you know, collage the shards of the broken plate over like glass and then kind of just paint over it and calm down. It's really literal shards of my anxiety. Parang also, this is the only artwork that only that's with me right now. Everything else, I don't know where they are or. I'll never see them until 2021. Like, if they're in other locations, I can't see them. So yeah, this was made during the quarantine. And yeah, it's not perfect. I had no intention to make it perfect. I was really trying to calm down. Like, there were no technical, like, it's collage, so I just let my mind and soul into it. And yeah, art is a type of therapy. Don't break your plate,
it is. Yeah, as much as you can. Our next question, actually this is the last question. It's also from the audience. This is for Mara naman. So Mara there. So how do you choose or make images that make up your collages? This is a good question because you draw inspiration from all sorts of things also. Mm-hmm. And when we look at your art, we see, you know, small pieces of things coming from a whole image. So how do you choose what to use or, you know, what to put into your art?
I think I would chalk it up lang to intuition. I honestly don't know. Because parang when I'm, like, now my process is I have, like, magazines. And when I flip through it, and then sometimes I see something which like catches my eye, and like what Marika said earlier, parang like you think like, oh, that's pretty, you know. And then I sometimes cut them and I save them for a future collage. So yeah, sometimes it's the color, other times it's the form. Maybe like I cut part of a whole form, like part of somebody's jacket on a fashion spread or something. I think that's interesting. And yeah, it's really kind of this intuition that tells me like, this could be interesting. This could have a story to tell.
Yeah. So the follow-up question there is, do you create the initial images? Do you create the initial images? That's for you.
No, but I would like, now it's from other sources, from like magazines, sometimes from newspapers, but I would like to, you know, moving forward, maybe create like those visual textures or images myself. So as of now, I'm just like I'm having too much fun with like magazine collages.
Wait, thank you, Hara. We have one interesting question from the audience. The question is for all of you ladies. So as a woman, what are the challenges the most as an artist in the Philippine art scene? So what are your challenges? I think this is coming from Ellie Kial. Oh, Ellie. Ellie's one another artist that we will feature soon. Thank you for the question, Ellie. So the question is, what is probably the greatest challenge that you've experienced being an artist in the Philippine art scene? So this is our last question for this episode.
Can I start?
Yes. Go, Marika.
All right. What challenges do you face most? Okay, so personally, I'm quite okay because I've built a platform in which I could represent myself and the women in my community. But in terms of what my artist friends are saying and their greatest challenge, I also feel is, you know, underrepresentation still in the art scene. So simple things like in the last semester, I taught contemporary art, Philippine art, and like in the textbook palang, like there's literally no women artists. It's just Pasita Abad. And I'm like,
yes.
What about my female students? What if they want more contemporary Philippine artists they want to look up to? And that's hindi nila kabayad si Pasita. So where's everyone else, diba? Or like if you go to like mga museums, you can count the amount of women who are like there, and even in mga art magazines, you'll find like parang sinalang yung babae, you know, for the sake of, you know, women empowerment. But I don't really feel the presence of the woman, right? And so I think it's great that there's a lot of women artists who are starting their own thing. So me, I feel like I can represent myself, and I'm being represented well by Art Talk PH. Because we are led by a woman, you know, and like women curators, how are you guys, you know, it feels like it's a competition like all the time over there. And so it reflects on the artist that you will end up representing. You will choose, it will be more gender specific, diba? Kasi syempre, competition na siya. So syempre, you feature the privileged gender. It's true. Like, be aware of our privilege. Yun. So yun lang ang ano ko. I think the greatest challenge, not just in the Philippine art scene, but globally.
It is, yeah.
We can rise.
It is a challenge.
Yeah. Thank you.
Mara, do you want to answer the question?
William, that's a good question, and Marika gave a really good answer. I would say that it is also underrepresentation. Like, for example, we haven't had a female national artist for painting yet, right? And, you know, I'm not saying anything, but like, you know, yeah, like we have so many like powerhouse female artists working now who are still working, who have been working for a long time, and who deserve that same level of like accolades that male artists have. For me personally, one thing that I also want to hopefully overcome is this idea that like as a female artist, you have to have this, you have to adhere to this certain aesthetic of like feminist art, of art that well has decidedly like, I guess, dainty or feminist qualities, or that there's a certain, yeah, you know, you have to pigeonhole yourself like into this like parang box of feminist art. Yeah. So, you know, like as female artists, you know, you can do whatever kind of art you want. Or if you want to have this like feminist art, then go ahead. But like, you know, just as male artists don't have to be confined to this idea of masculine or male art, neither do female artists have to be confined into this idea of feminine art. So yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Mara. Annalie, would you like to answer the question?
Okay. Ako naman kasi parang dun pa lang naman sa art scene, parang ang hirap na rin talagang mag-crawl or pumunta mismo parang para mapunta sa art scene talaga. Mahirap na talaga yun. So parang siguro ang struggle lang as a woman sa amin. Siguro kasi kunyari yung mga painting namin or what. Madalas kaming na kukutan as madrama or what, parang ganyan, 'di ba? Parang men, hindi naman lahat, pero for meron dahilan palagi parang para sa bayan or what, kailangan palagi may pinaglalaban or what. Eh kasi ako naman yung artwork ko or mostly as na women, we tackle more about inside, parang our struggle inside, di ba? So parang yun yung mas importante sa amin as a women, kasi parang as a person din, paano ka makakapag-contribute sa lahat kung ikaw itself, yung sarili mo, hindi mo alam kung paano mo siya maayos or ma-organize or what, di ba? Parang paano mo siya, paano ka makakatulong sa pangkalahatan kung yung sarili mo hindi mo matutulungan. So kami, mostly na nakikita ko mga babae na art, na artist, mga artwork, parang gano'n, nagde-dwell inside, parang gano'n. So, kasi ang problema, mostly, di ba nga, masculine yung mga, ano, ng mga lalaki, so parang, kami naku-quote ng madrama or what, doing naman lahat, hindi to lahat. Parang meron lang instances na gano'n ang nangyari, gano'n ang nangyayari. Parang, hindi nabibigyan ng importance yung work ng mga babae tsaka yung gustong iparating ng mga babae sa art nila. Parang ganun. Parang hindi naman lahat ng artwork kailangan laban. Laban palabas. Hindi. Kailangan laban din paloob. So, mas marami tayong maibibigay. Parang ganun. Ayun.
Thank you, Annalie. I really like what you said. That is so true. Why? It's been almost 40 minutes. Thank you, ladies, for joining us tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you. And to our audience, thank you for joining us in our first episode of Brush with Artists. Again, if you want to view Marika Kalyangan of Woman Creates Art, Mara Fabella, Anna Angeles Art, please visit our platform artstockph.com. It's all there. You can also read the narratives there. And if you want to list your art to the artist, please just send us a DM on our Instagram. Our Instagram is at artstockph. And again, thank you for joining us tonight. And we'll see you on the next episode next week.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you. Bye.